you'll often see operons used as models for prokaryotic gene regulation, and especially this one because it's a little bit different. Hi, biology friends, it's Sarah, your other biology professor, and let's talk about the trp operon. Expression of the tryptophan, or trp operon, is regulated by two different mechanisms, a classic negative repressible mechanism and by attenuation, and we'll look at both in this video. Remember that an operon is a cluster of genes organized together and controlled by a single promoter. That means that the genes are either transcribed or not transcribed together. And for the trp operon in E. coli, there are five genes that are part of this cluster. They are transcribed to make a single mRNA that is translated to produce five different enzymes involved in the production of the amino acid tryptophan. Other sequences on the operon act as signals for regulation, allowing for proteins to bind and turn transcription on or off based on cellular conditions. So upstream of the structural genes, you'll find the promoter. That's where RNA polymerase will bind in order to initiate transcription. And between the promoter and the structural genes, you'll find the operator, a region where a regulatory protein will bind. And for the trp operon, the regulatory protein is called the trp repressor. It's produced by a separate gene that's not part of the operon. How do these proteins and DNA sequences work to control expression of the trp operon? Well, it makes a little bit more sense if you keep the function in mind. What do the structural genes do? They encode enzymes for tryptophan biosynthesis, the production of tryptophan. That means that the cell's going to want to keep transcribing the structural genes, producing plenty of mRNA to make plenty of enzymes to make tryptophan, until it doesn't need any more tryptophan. This means that the trp operon is a repressible operon. Its default state, sort of typical state, is in the on position, transcribing the structural genes so that the cell can make tryptophan. But the trp operon can be repressed, expression, transcription can be turned off under certain conditions. And that condition is, we got enough tryptophan. When tryptophan is piling up, the trp repressor, which until now has just been kind of hanging out in the background, the trp repressor will bind to some of that excess tryptophan. This is going to cause a shape change or a conformational change in the trp repressor, opening up a DNA binding site. The trp repressor is going to go bind to the operator region. The operator region overlaps the promoter just a little bit, so that means that when the trp repressor is bound to the operator, it's blocking RNA polymerase from being able to come in to bind to the promoter to initiate transcription. Having a regulatory protein like the trp repressor that inhibits transcription when it binds to the operon is called negative gene regulation. That means that the trp operon is both negative and repressible. It's a negative repressible operon. And for more on that and the other types of operons, I'll link a video in the description. Now, once the cell starts to use up that backlog of tryptophan and the tryptophan concentration falls in the cell, tryptophan will fall off of the trp repressor and the trp repressor will leave the operator. And once it's out of the way, RNA polymerase can come in and do its thing. Now, we've already mentioned that the trp operon's a little bit different because it can be regulated in another way, by attenuation. You'll see attenuation used on operons involved in the production of amino acids. And the reason for that will make a bit more sense when we get into it. Let's add a little detail to our diagram of the trp operon. Just upstream of the structural genes is a region called the leader region, or tRPL. And when transcription is on, that leader region is transcribed and produces an mRNA that has four subregions or domains. And those regions have areas of complementarity. They can pair up. Pairing causes hairpins to form in the mRNA. So domain one can pair with domain two to form a hairpin, two can pair with three, and three can pair with four. But Each domain can only be involved in one hairpin at a time. So which hairpins form? Well, that's all about where the ribosome is. Wait, the ribosome. Translation. Yes. Remember that in prokaryotes, there's no nucleus. So that means that transcription and translation happen in the same space. And well before you're done transcribing an mRNA, a ribosome has already hopped on to translate it. In fact, there's actually a little pause built into the leader region to make sure that RNA polymerase waits for the ribosome and doesn't get too far ahead. In the mRNA that is produced from that first domain, there are instructions for making a very short peptide. So you've got a start codon, a stop codon, and in between that are two adjacent codons that encode the amino acid tryptophan. If there is a high concentration of tryptophan in the cell, there will be plenty of tRNAs charged with tryptophan to deliver tryptophan to those two codons. That means that the ribosome can move quickly through region 1, blocking region 2, which allows 3 and 4 to form a hairpin. The 3-4 hairpin is a termination hairpin. This is a type of row-independent termination if you've studied that. But if not, essentially, it just means that it's going to cause instability. It's going to cause RNA polymerase to fall off, terminating transcription. So we're not going to get transcription of the structural genes that are going to help make more tryptophan, which is fine because there's plenty of tryptophan in the cell. But what if there's not plenty of tryptophan in the cell? What if the concentration is low? Well, in that case, when the ribosome gets to those two tryptophan codons, it's gonna have to wait a minute. It's gonna stall out. Low tryptophan in the cell means there's not a lot of tRNAs charged with tryptophan just hanging around. The ribosome gets stuck. That means it's not blocking region 2, so 2 and 3 will form a hairpin. It's absolutely no problem for RNA polymerase. It's gonna keep moving along to transcribe the structural genes to get us more tryptophan, increase that concentration. It's a little complicated, so let's summarize attenuation. Basically, when tryptophan is high, the ribosome can fly. It's gonna go quickly through region 1, blocking region 2, and allowing for that 3-4 termination hairpin. That means that we're not gonna get transcription of the structural genes, which is fine, we've got plenty of tryptophan. Now, when tryptophan is low, the ribosome is slow, right? It's gonna stall out on those two tryptophan codons. And because it's sitting there, it's stalled out, it's not blocking region 2, 2, 3 form an anti-termination hairpin, allowing for RNA polymerase to keep on transcribing into the structural genes to make some more tryptophan. Attenuation works for operons with genes involved in the production of amino acids, but it wouldn't work for something like the lac operon. Why? Well, there's no codons that encode lactose. It's not an amino acid. So you don't get the dynamic of the ribosome stalling or not stalling in response to the concentrations in the cell. Now, if you're wondering, why use repression and attenuation? Why both methods? Well, repression can knock down transcription most of the way when you don't need it, but it's not perfect. The trip repressor can fall off, allowing RNA polymerase to sort of sneak in there and get transcription going, even when you don't really need it. So attenuation can act as a way to stop transcription that's unnecessary after it's already started. Let's put it all together. So when the tryptophan levels in the cell are high, that little baby E. coli cell does not need to make any more tryptophan. And so the trp operon is regulated in a negative repressible manner by the actions of the trp repressor protein, which will block RNA polymerase from transcribing those structural genes to make more tryptophan. We don't need it anyway. And attenuation can further regulate expression by stopping unneeded transcription after it's already begun. And when tryptophan levels in the cell are low, no repression, no attenuation, transcription is on. RNA polymerase is transcribing in order to crank out directions for making more enzymes to add to those tryptophan levels in the cell. If the trip operon makes just a little bit more sense now, please give me a thumbs up so that other students can find my content as well. In the meantime, subscribe so you don't miss any more biology from me. Check out my website for tutoring resources, and I will see you next time.